This is Nicholas Stasinski.
And this is Paul Russell.
We are RoboChamps VexIQ team.
This year's VexIQ STEM project theme is math. We decided to research how we can make kids more interested in math. We came up with the idea of a vending machine that would give discounts to students who answered math questions correctly.
A vending machine is a robot that dispenses small items when a coin, token, or a bill is inserted.
Vending machines vary from really simple ones like this
to fully digital ones like this.
The first United States vending machine sold gum on New York City train platform starting in 1888. There was a vending machine in England in the 1930s that dispensed nuggets of coal.
There is a vending machine that dispenses bars or coins of pure gold in the United Arab Emirates. Vending machines are so notorious that one is even placed in Fortnite game world.
Modern vending machines have different payment methods such as credit card, Apple Pay, and Google Pay.
The building process of the vending machine can be as varied as the products dispensed in them. The body is made from a roll or coil of galvanized steel. Steel sheets lie flat as the presses crimp the edges, creating bends in the metal and forming the steel into the cabinet's basic shape.
Vending machines are usually stalled and stocked all at no cost. However, if you're looking to purchase a soda vending machine, generally they start around $3,600. Snack machines start around $3,000 because they do not need to be refrigerated.
Completing a transaction is a bit more complicated. The simplest way is to pop your change into a standard vending machine. Machines can recognize different types of bills by scanning them, and coins by recognizing their size and weight. With a Zoom Systems machine, a customer swipes his or her debit card for purchase authorization. Some machines, like those for Macy's and Best Buy's, also accept gift cards.
And this is our vending machine.
Since we don't have access to expensive metal material and a hydraulic press, we decided to build our own prototype out of scrap wood, cardboard, and paint, and program my little sister to operate it.
First, we built the rectangular wooden frame and covered its three sides with cardboard. We spray painted the cardboard and cut out and decorated openings for different functions.
The first opening is for inserting bills or coins. Second opening is for our digital interface, where we place our tablet. Third opening is for dispersing the change, and the biggest opening is for items dispenser. How is it going to work?
Our special math-encouraging vending robot would be placed in the schoolyard. When the student decides to buy something, he will scan his school ID on the interface to determine his grade and math question difficulty.
Next, he or she will choose an item from the menu and insert the money or using Zoom system on the interface.
Here comes our math question. The machine is going to pull a question from its math question database according to his or her grade level and ask the student. The student will have a multiple choice question to make, and if he answers correctly, then they would get a 50 cents discount. The money that our vending machine makes of bad answers would go to support the PTA.
How long would it take for the PTA machine to be profitable? We think that we should let every student use the machine only once a day so the smart kids don't get us bankrupt.
For example, we've calculated that if 100 students use the vending machine every school day, then the cost of the machine is $3,600 and 50% of students get the answer wrong, we would pay the machine off in 144 days.
Baby, can't you see I'm calling?